see you've got your guitars you're already itching to play.
Just so happen to have them right here.
We'll have a chat first. Tell us how it all started. Obviously, you were born at a very early age.
Yes.
At the same time.
I was pretty young then. I can't really remember.
Yeah.
Well, we've always been around music. Our family was, we came from a musical background. My dad was Rick Nelson, and his parents actually had a big band as well. So music being always around us, we picked up instruments when we were 7 and started playing together. Around age 12, we started playing in the Los Angeles nightclubs. And around age 18, we had something that could have probably been pretty big in the States. And my father passed away, and it really kind of threw us for a loop. And it's just one of a bunch of things that really made us want to pull back and reevaluate ourselves and learn how to write and learn how to get better at our craft.
The press was pretty hard on you with all that, the situation with your father. How did you cope with all that?
Well, it was tough. You know, the best way really to do it was to travel and just meet people in different places and maybe people that weren't really that well informed on the accident, or if they were, that had a different viewpoint about it. People in America tend to be kind of jaded.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we took a really good trip to Australia. That really helped us out.
Right, that was almost a turning point or something that helped you along in your career. Mm-hmm. What do you think of Australians?
I love Australians. We really kind of owe them something. At a point in our lives when we were really kind of confused about people in general, Australians tended to be very real at a time when we needed it. Mm-hmm. We needed to be called on a lot of stuff. As far as we were going personally, we were heading down the wrong roads.
Right, we had a lot of work to do.
Yeah,
and fortunately, when we traveled in Australia, we met a lot of people that pointed out the fact that we had a lot of work to do on ourselves before the music would come together.
Mm-hmm.
We were always saying to ourselves, well, geez, why isn't the music happening? Why aren't we signed yet? What's going on?
Why don't these people see it? And really, it was inside of us.
It was inside of us. And only then, when it was pointed out to us, could we become focused. The music became focused in turn. And then it all started happening from there.
What happened when you got back? You thought, right, let's go mad. Let's go into Geffen Records.
Well, the most important thing is that we knew that, as far as the music was concerned, that it was a big world out there.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of musicians in Los Angeles tend to only use L.A. as it's like their own little bubble world. And as long as they're successful in Los Angeles, or they make music that appeals only to Los Angelians or Americans, then they're going to be fine. But it's a big world out there, and we wanted it to be an international sound and an international band.
Mm-hmm.
That really, really had a big impact. It broadened our horizons quite a bit.
It helped and gave an Australian guitar player. Huh?
Yeah.
Well, that's right, because these guys actually pinched one of our Australian guitar players from the John Farnham band. John, if you're watching, I know you're pretty upset about the whole thing.
Sorry,
how did you meet him?
Well, actually, it was through our manager in Australia, a guy named Jeff Shoecraft.
Mm.
He called us up one day. We were in making demos. We made 56 demos for the record, so it was over about a 3-year period. So we were back in the demo phase, and we were starting to put the band together, and Jeff called us one day and said, God, you guys would not believe it. I saw the most incredible guitar player.
You were sure.
Yeah, exactly. Sure. I said, yeah, come on.
And
come on,
you know, the normal kind of came out of nowhere, taught himself how to play on a farm kind of thing.
Right.
And he did. And he sounds unlike anybody else. And that's really what we wanted. We wanted a band of virtuoso players, but a band that didn't sound like anything else. A band that sounded like Nelson.
Well, when you, to get your actual record deal, you just marched into the office of a record executive with your guitar, just like you are now, and you played acoustically.
It was more or less. It was after about a year's worth of negotiations that weren't going anywhere, and we just decided to go for it.
We just got frustrated and got our confidence back. Between the lawyers and managers and everything, no one could get it together to finally ink the deal.
Mm.
And for a couple of guys living out of the trunk of their car and stuff, we really needed to get the deal pushed through.
Well, you've got a bit of an audience here. The crew's looking very keen.
Right on. All right, guys.
A couple of people sitting over there. Why don't you play us a little tune that we all know and love in Australia?
We would love to.
Well, when we went into the office, this is kind of what it sounded like.
Right.
Okay.
Ready?
Two, three, four.